Given a plain text input, the encryption algorithm performs transformation to produce the corresponding ciphertext. The decryption algorithm reverses the encryption process. That is, it takes as input the ciphertext and produces the original plain text. Instead of using a single key, as in the symmetric encryption, here, asymmetric encryption uses a pair of keys. One is used for encryption, and the other is used for decryption. The two keys are paired mathematically together. That is, if you use a key for encryption, only the corresponding paired key can decrypt the message. Let's look at the essential steps in asymmetric encryption. First, each user generates a pair of keys that are paired together mathematically. One is the private key, the other is the public key. The public key can be published, for example, on a user's website or on a public repository. The purpose is for everybody to know your public key. But a companion private key has to be kept as a secret. That is, only the user should know his or her own private key. Since public keys are meant to be known by others, we can imagine that in practice, a user such as Bob would have a collection of public keys of his friends. For example, in this case, Bob has the public keys of Alice, Ted, Mike, and Joy. Now suppose Bob wants to send a private message to Alice. Bob will use Alice's public key, which is in his collection, to encrypt a plain text using an asymmetric encryption algorithm, such as RSA, and then transmit the ciphertext to Alice. It is mathematically guaranteed that only Alice can decrypt this ciphertext properly into plain text, because only Alice has the corresponding companion private key. That is, if a public key is used to encrypt a plain text into the ciphertext, only the companion corresponding private key can decrypt the ciphertext properly into the plain text. Therefore, in this case, only Alice can see the plain text.